the next question is this. Is it the duty of God to solve all our problems and the world problems or any other problems? First, let me know what a problem is. Problem is created by me. My problem is created by me. Your problem is created by you. Why should I ask God to solve my problem? I keep my hand in fire, it gets burned. Oh God, this is my problem, solve it. He will say, why did you put your hand in the fire? You made the problem. So I consume poison. It leads to death. Oh God, I am going to die. Solve my problem. He will say, why did you consume poison? So cause and effect. You are the cause for your problem. Therefore, let me not say, it's God's problem. It's not His problem. Your problem, you have created. You have to solve it. At the most, by praying to Him, He will help you to solve the problem. He will show you the way to solve the problem. I cannot blame God that you are my problem, that you have created problem. No, 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 no. We are the creators of our own problem. Let us pray to Him so that He will show us a way to come out of the problems. The world problems are His problems. It's not the world problem. It's not a global problem. Let everybody work for our own problems by taking responsibility for all that is happening so that the world will be free from problems. Thank you. Well, as a human being, what is our duty when we see wrongdoing in the world? Our duty is to be perfect on our side. When I am perfect on my side, I can correct anybody. By love, you see, it was Jesus Christ who said, judge not, lest thou shalt be judged. If you start judging everybody, you are wrong. Well, let me not be wrong. Don't judge anybody. Therefore, you will be judged tomorrow. What I can say is, it is not my duty to see wrongdoing. Why don't you see right doing? To see the right things happening is positive attitude. To see only right wrong things happening everywhere is negative attitude. By this negative attitude, you cannot remove negativity. No, you cannot make everybody free from wrongdoings. Let me be positive. At the most, I can help people to be positive. I can talk to people lovingly, with love. I can bring them along the right path. Not simply saying, you are wrong, you are doing wrong things. No, no, that will give you wrong results. That will give you negative results. By being loving, you can bring them along the right path. That's what we are supposed to do. Thank you. Is the world a good place or a bad place? You make it good or bad. As Swami gives an example. Here I have a knife. With this knife, I can cut the fruit and eat it. With the same knife, I can commit suicide. I can chop off my neck. Same knife. So, knife can be used for good purpose and also for bad purpose. Nothing to do with the knife. Knife won't kill you unless you kill yourself with the knife. The knife won't act unless you take that knife and cut the vegetables or fruits. Therefore, you make it the world good or bad. World is good. World is good. You make it bad. It depends on you to make it good or bad. The world is free. The world is available to you. The world is at your disposal. World is divine. It is for you to make use of it. Thank you. The next question Why do we lose our health? What do we need to regain our health? Why do we lose our health? Because of irregular diet, because of lack of exercise, because of absence of discipline, because of mental restlessness, worry, anxiety. So physically we are weak because of our poor dietary habits, irregular dining. Addition to that, bad habits like smoking, drinking, non-vegetarian stuff. That will make our health spoiled. Worry, tension, anxiety, mentally, that also makes our health very poor. So let us be healthy by being regular in our habits. Let us have mental peace by practicing meditation. Meditation for the mind, exercise, dietary regulation for the body will help us to be healthy, wealthy and wise. Otherwise, we lose our health. Let us be careful in these two habits, two areas. How to regain health? Well, as I suggested you, physical level at the mental level. Thank you very much. As a devotee, what do you think about spiritual persons today? What they are lacking? I think spirituality is more an exhibition today. It is more a pretension today. The spirituality is not genuine today. What we are lacking is, we come to spirituality for material gains, for worldly gains, for this mundane world. Spirituality is not for that. Spirituality is not for worldly gains or worldly profits. Spirituality is little above. What we are lacking today is this viveka, discrimination, vijnana, wisdom, vairagya, detachment, renunciation. People with this viveka, discrimination, vairagya, renunciation, vijnana, wisdom, they are the spiritual people. People with desires are not spiritual. You can say they are religious, they are not spiritual. Being religious meaning you want to have your desires fulfilled. Being spiritual, you are above want. You are above desire. That's what it is. What we lack today, these three, vijnana, viveka and vairagya. Discrimination, wisdom and then detachment or renunciation. Thank you. Well, the next question is, should we make an effort to progress in the spiritual path or leave it to God? God helps those who help themselves. You have to walk. He will take care of you so that you don't fall. You have to read. God helps you to keep it in memory. You have to eat. God helps you to digest it. Therefore, you do it, then He will take care of you. Without doing it, Swami, you take care of eating, you take care of breathing, then what's your job? Are you vegetable like that? He has given you the brain. He has given you sense of thinking, discrimination, determination. Why don't you exercise those qualities? Swami has given an example. Here is a plate with puris served there. Well, oh God, take my puris right into my mouth, right into gullet. No, no, no. Food is served there. You have to eat it. Similarly, it is your job to take to work and He will bless you with success ultimately. Therefore, I cannot leave it to God like a lazy person. He will say, what are you doing? And Swami gave an example. It seems a fellow fell from the bullock cart. He fell down. And he was praying, "Oh Rama, what are you doing? I fell down." And he cried and cried and went to sleep, got into sleep. There in the dream, Rama appears and tells him, "Wake up, get up, take the support of the wheel and get up. Well, why are you lazy like that?" Then he realizes, "Oh, here is a wheel, let me take hold of it, and then he tries to get up. In a similar way, God is our support. He is our succor. He is our anchor. He is our pillar of support, provided you are prepared to receive it, provided you are aware of the divine support. Therefore, the progress in spiritual path is totally left to you. Be willing to progress. Be willing to advance. Take the first step and he will walk with us 100 steps. That's what Baba said. Take one step, I'll take 100 steps with you. Therefore, God is always ready to help us, provided I am ready to receive his help. Unless you turn towards your camera, he cannot take your picture. If I turn my back, you will not get your picture. So turn to God, he will take picture. He will come readily to help us at every point of our life. Thank you. Why we are not able to bear the suffering that is happening in the world today? You are not suffering for what is happening in the world. You are suffering because of what is happening in you. I am not suffering when the other people are suffering. I am not suffering. They are suffering because of their mistakes, because of their own fault. Why should I suffer? Therefore, actually speaking, I am suffering because of my own problems, because of my own deeds, because of my own words, because of my own behavior. Therefore, I need to know why I am suffering. Then I will find the cause and also the way how to get out of the suffering. The world is not suffering me. I am suffering for myself. So let me know the cause and work it out to be free from. Easy solution. Pray to Swami. Pray to Swami. Think of him. Sing his glory. All problems will run away from you. But we look at the problem, but we don't find out the solution. Solution to the problem is surrendering to God. O Swami, I surrender to you. Thy will be done as it is in heaven, is Lord's prayer. Is our prayer to Lord. Let your will prevail. And with that surrender, we can get out of personal problem. That is the best solution. Thank you.